I was broken. Oh, but now I'm in debt again. And scars just remind me God's grace always finds me. I was broken. Now I'm mended again. Dominate my mind with your word. Dominate my mind with your word. Dominate my mind with your holy word. Dominate my mind with your word. Dominate my mouth with your word. Dominate my mouth with your word. Dominate my mouth with your holy word. Dominate my mouth with your word. Dominate my home with your word. Dominate my home with your word. I never go through my house commanding devils to leave, because they don't come. It's a very uncomfortable house for demons. Dominate my house with your word. Just turn on your iPod and start singing these songs to the Holy Spirit. Demons will leave voluntarily. Dominate my home with your word. Oh, dominate my home with your holy word. Dominate my home with your word. Dominate my mouth with your word. Go ahead and touch your mouth. That's your deliverer. I said, that's your deliverer. Ah. Now stroke it like a little. Ah. Just say, it's my deliverer. Dominate my mouth with your word. Dominate my mouth with your holy word. Dominate my mouth with your word. Anything you want. Anything you ask. Whatever you desire. Lord, just name the task. That's what I will do. Oh, that's what I will do, precious Holy Spirit. I'm in love with you. I'm in love. 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 I'm in love with you. I want to hear your voice. I want to hear your voice. Nothing else really matters. But your choice. I want to live unhindered. My life fully surrendered. I want to hear. I want to hear your voice. Make my life count, Lord. I see my brother stumble and all his dreams crumble. Let me be there for I to fail. When I see been taking, let me be there, for I remember so very well. I want to spend my whole life mending broken people. I want to spend my whole life removing somebody's pain. Lord, let my words heal a heart that hurts. I want to spend my whole life mending broken people. When you've got nothing left but God, nothing left but God, you've still got enough to start again. And no matter what men have ever taken, what they've taken out of your hands, when you've got nothing left but God, when you've got nothing left but God, when you've got nothing left but God. You've got enough to start again. Oh, you can start again. You can start again. Oh, you can start again. Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up, and start again. You can make it. Oh, you can make it. This trial you're going through, God's gonna show you just what to do. You can make it. Oh, you can make it. Oh, I don't care what's going wrong. God won't let it last too long. You're not in this thing alone. You can make it.
God. I am so tempted to sing all 5,800 songs that the Lord has put in my heart. How many would stay here for at least a dozen of them? Wow. Don't you love that song? On one of the worst days of my life, the worst day of my life, I'm sitting at the piano. And I looked at a friend of mine, Alton Garrison, and he said, Mike, you're going to make it. You can make it. And he was sitting on the sofa, and I was sitting at my white piano. You can make it. And I took off singing that song. You can make it. You can make it. This trial you're going through, this trial you're going through, God's gonna show you just what to do. You can make it. Oh, you can make it. I don't care what's going wrong. I don't care what's going wrong. God won't let it last too long. Oh, you're not in this thing alone. You can make it. Hallelujah. God took that song around the world. Everywhere I went, people were singing that song. It was on bumper stickers on all millions of cars. Television programs made it their theme song. You can make it. You can make it. I'd go into stores around the world, shops, and they'd look at me and say, you can make it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can make it. You can make it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many is glad there's something inside of you that makes trouble for troublemakers? Hallelujah. 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 You may be seated. I want to share for a few moments, and I've been watching the wonderful teaching going on all day today. And it's just glorious. And Pastor Gonzalez, things that you said just kind of, oh, I did not know those words from you. And I just almost started crying watching you today. Thank you. Thank you for every word. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Wow. You just really need those good words. You really need those good words. You really do. I want to talk to you for a few moments. Pastor Monica, can they make that real fast? Do you have some people that can let me? I'm not tired, but I want to change up here to a seat so I can talk to you. Pastor Monica, yeah, we're right here. Right here, son, who can come move this pulpit? Who can move the pulpit? Watch the water there. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, thank you, son. We don't like something, we just change it. Till we do. I'll take that little thank you. Yes, this is okay. A little further up. I'm not a backseat guy. Some of you don't want to get too close to me, but it doesn't stop me from getting close to you. So we'll do this. Ah, great. Thanks. Thanks. Some of the wisdom that we've heard this weekend is profound in its impact on us. There's almost nothing in the world we cannot do if we believe it, if we believe it. Years ago, I flew to Baltimore, Maryland. Two drivers picked me up at the airport. And they were bragging on how, I said, how is the conference going? They said, oh, it's wonderful, wonderful. I said, so what did you do today differently? They looked at each other and said, pretty good question, isn't it? They said, say that again. I said, you said last night was a glorious conference. So I'd like to know what you did differently today. Information that doesn't improve you is unnecessary. And one of the master keys to success is staying focused on the necessary. Most information on the earth is not important to you. I'll say it again. Most information on the earth has nothing to do with you. Knowing what you should be learning is the strategy. What should I be learning about? We were dissecting a frog in school one day, and I lifted my hand to the teacher and I said, now why are we doing this? And the teacher said, you will need this someday. Liar, liar. I have never needed it. To this day, I've never needed the word nomenclature, molecules. I go entire days without saying those words. I've gone weeks without discussing the distance to the sun. Think of how many stupid people have made stupid deposits in you. It takes you a lifetime to get them out of you. Algebra. I lifted my hand. Why are we, I don't understand. X plus Y.